Fort Gordon is a Army military site for soldiers as well as civilians and contractors.
These soldiers learn the signal command for the United States Army. We have a lot of what they call IET soldiers that come in and train, so we need to issue them the equipment that they need to use. They may come in for duffel bags, helmets, IBA vests, the plates that go with it, all of those kind of things that they consider mission essential.
We support heating and air conditioning. We do the water treatment. There are 9 wells out here where the soldiers go and get water when they're out in the field, and we make sure it's safe and good to drink. We have enough cooling and heating to cool and heat a small city. We do the maintenance on the chillers and the boilers and high temp generators, all the pumps, compressors, cooling tower fans, gearboxes, you name it, we do it. We're a 24-hour operation, and we are to provide safe and continuous service to our soldiers.
Our main equipment here is for training as well as supporting any reserve units. We repair medical equipment, defibrillators, x-rays, suctions, vital sign monitors. Something breaks down or needs a component or upgrade, we also do those services.
Oh, I work on night vision goggles, and I do targets, vacuum cleaners, buffers, anything that needs to be, you know, repaired.
I'm a full-time bus driver, transporting soldiers to and from. The soldiers have to go and have other training to other places like Fort Benning or Fort Jackson, Savannah, Statesboro, you name it, we go. We take them to the airport, and we're glad to see them when they come back. You get to know each other, you know, and you get to know their attitude, their personality, and it's just like family.
I work with a good team. I work in the maintenance division, 15 SIG motor pool. We maintain the vehicles for the units, the tactical vehicles, Humvees, 1165A1s. I process the paperwork, the work orders, and our soldiers, they come here, they get the vehicles, and I dispatch them. The best part of all of it is the soldiers. It's just a wonderful thing to be working with a great group of people.
When they get off the bus, most of them will say, "Thank you, ma'am, have a good day."
We really do the best that we know how to do for them.
I entered this field as a soldier and then transferred from Army to civilian life, and to still be able to put a hand into working with the Army is a blessing.
This is just something that I can do to help them to make sure they're squared away. They have what they need to perform their mission.
I think it's important that every job have a union.
If you didn't have the union, to me, you'd be up the creek without a paddle.
You never know what situation you may be put in that you just need that extra support, whether it's for advice or an opinion or just to lead you in the right direction of what needs to be accomplished.
It's for your benefit.
You just have someone on your side.